pass by them roundabouts, and behold, there were very many bones in the open valley, and also they were very, very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. Again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. That says the Lord unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into them, and they shall live. And I will lay sinews upon them, and will bring up, and I'll bring up flesh upon them, and cover them with skin, and put breath in them, and they shall live. And they shall know that I am the Lord. So I prophesied as I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold, a shaking. And the bones came together, bones to bones. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came upon them, and the skin covered them above, but there was no breath in them. Then say he unto me, prophesy to the wind, prophesy, son of man, and say to the wind, that says the Lord, come from the four winds, O breath, and breath upon these slain, and they shall live. So I prophesied as I was commanded. Verse 10, so I prophesied as I was commanded, and breath came upon them, and they live, and they stood up upon their feet, an exceedingly great army. May the Lord bless the reading of his word.
Amen.
This is a story of Ezekiel, the story of the dry bones. Today I say unto you, your dry bones shall live.
Amen.
That which has been completely forgotten, just as the dry bone, they shall live again.
Yes.
And things that has been considered as impossible in our life shall be possible today in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We shall be singing a new song also in the name of Jesus Christ. And very soon, and I believe that very soon, each of us will be singing a new song.
Amen.
The story of the dry bone is a classical story of a dry season that you're passing through, like a classical story that describes the difficulty times that you can be passing through in your life. And when the Bible was describing the dry bones, the Bible says they were dead, very, very dead, so that they were so dry, like they were very, very dry, that even when God asked his prophets to prophesy, he said to God, this, my faith, is not up to that level. But God said to the prophets, open your mouth and talk. This morning, God is saying to you, open your mouth and declare on that situation in your life that has become a dry bone, a dry land for you. When you speak, God will do the rest in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What God was saying is that at that level of situation that we are in, our strength cannot do it. But if we trust on him, he will do the work for you. And I believe that somebody is going to have faith this morning and will speak to that situation in your life, and it shall be well with you in the name of Jesus Christ. Dry bones. Dry bones. When we read the story, We saw that when God told Ezekiel to prophesy, he did prophesy unto the dry bones. And each time that he prophesies, whatever God says comes to pass. And we got to the point that they saw these dry bones became an army. But there was one thing that was lacking to them. That is the breath of life. And God says to him, prophesy to the winds, let the wind blow. Hallelujah. Yes. This morning the wind is going to blow in your life. All the mortal things that is in your life will come back to life in the name of Jesus Christ. So we are going to talk about the wind of the Holy Spirit. When the wind blows. In this story, we can see some few things. So we'll take some few points in this story. Then we'll go to prayer. Number one, when the wind blows, hopeless situations receive hope again. Hallelujah. Remember, the Bible says the bones were very, very dry. There is no hope in that situation. That is why the man of God himself told God that my faith is not up to that level. Says it is only you who can do it, God.
Yes.
I pray that any hopeless situation in your life this morning, or you will receive hope in it in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
The Bible describes that when the wind blew over these bones, life came back unto them. That is what is going to happen this morning. The wind is going to blow in your life. Life is going to restore. Things that are hopeless in your life, oh, they will receive hope today in the name of Jesus Christ. Things that you think has been abandoned, that nobody even consider them to be any good thing, you shall sing a new song to that in the name of Jesus Christ. Because the wind is going to blow in your life this morning. Hallelujah. When we read the book of Colossians, Colossians chapter 1, verse 27, it says, Christ in you is the hope of glory. Christ in you is the hope of glory. He didn't say Christ in you is a hope of shame, but it says it is the hope of glory. And because the wind is going to blow on you this morning, and because Christ is in you, glory will be portion of your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. In the book of Genesis chapter 18, when you read from verse 10 to 14, it is a story that we know very well. It's a story about Abraham and Sarah, when God promised them that they're going to have a child. That is Genesis chapter 18 from verse 10 to 14. You know, it got to a time when God promised Sarah that she's going to have a child. Sarah was about 60 years old thereabout. And now she's 90 years old. And God said to her again that you are going to have a child. Humanly speaking, yes, I will do the same thing that Sarah did. She will laugh. How can my age, when I was even younger then, nothing didn't happen. And now that I'm 90 years old, and the husband is also about 100 years old at that time. Then Sarah laughed and God said something. You know, God is God. No one can be compared unto him. Whatever he said, it is done. If he opens the door, no one can shut it. And if he shuts that door, no one can open it. Therefore, whatever he says, I'd assure you that it will come to pass. Sarah laughed. But God says, you can laugh as much as you can. But because I'm God, whatever I said will come to pass. And I said to somebody here this morning, that whatever God has said about you, be rest assured that that will come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. Even if you don't believe it, because he is God and he has said it, it will happen. It will happen for you, it will happen for me, in the name of Jesus Christ. So what again that we see in this story when the wind blew? We saw that all lost opportunities were restored. All the lost opportunities were restored. These bones were armies. When God brought them back to life, they stood up as a great army, a seemingly great army that they were. But they may have done some work, but there were some opportunities for them that they should have done that at that point they couldn't do it, but God revisited them. Any lost opportunity in your life, God will revisit you and bring those opportunities back to life in the name of Jesus Christ. So those, they have to fulfill something. So they were back to life. And they need to do what they were, what was lost in their life. So the opportunities that they had were still there. So God has to send them back into that opportunity. In the book of Joel, Joel 2:25-27. And I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten, the canker worm and the caterpillar and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you. That it is what God is saying. So things that were lost before, he says, I will restore them back unto you. The opportunities that were lost before, God is saying to you this morning, he will restore them back to you. And verse 26, he continues, says, and ye shall eat in plenty. If you are walking in the dry land today, make sure that you buckle up very well, because plenty is coming. You shall eat plenty. That is what the Lord of hosts is saying. Believe it, and it shall be yours in the name of Jesus Christ. And ye shall be satisfied, and praise, which I love so much. When you find yourself in that situation where all the opportunities that you were lost is being restored back to you, do not forget to praise your God that restored those opportunities for you. Because he says he delights himself in, or he habits the praises of his children. When you praise God, all lost opportunities will be restored. I pray to someone tonight that you will praise God in your life, that every opportunity that is lost will be restored unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. Sometimes, even those opportunities that we lost, sometimes it's our own fault. Sometimes it is our own fault to lose those opportunities. Because sometimes you can see those opportunities right before your eyes. But because of the actions that you take, those opportunities are gone. I pray that will not be the portion of our life this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. When you look at the book of Judges chapter 16, the book of Judges chapter 16, verse 18 to 22, Judges 16, 18 to 22, it talks about the, I try to use these stories that we know very well so that you understand the value of what you have and the value of things that you have lost that are going to be restored. So it talks about Samson, how Samson lost all these opportunities that he has. He got disconnected from the Lord. That is one cure of us losing our opportunities. Once we get disconnected from the Lord, our opportunities get lost. And I pray that we will stay tuned with the Lord. We get connected with Him, and we will walk with Him hand in hand in the name of Jesus Christ. Samson get disconnected from the Lord. He put his trust on the lap of a woman. And the Bible says the woman cuts his hair. And the power that was given unto him was lost. And the enemy creeps in and chained him. I pray that God will give us the wisdom that every decision that we will make it right with Him in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says the enemy came in and chained him, and he has no power anymore. They blinded him and they put him in prison and they mocked him. Losing opportunities is not a good thing at all. Things that you can be, things that God has called you to be, those things are gone. But praise be to God. I said, praise be to God. In verse 22, the Bible says, Samson's hair began to grow again. Hallelujah. Samson's hair began to grow again. And I pray for every Samson in this room, not Samson, but anyone in the situations, just as Samson. I pray that all your opportunity will begin to come back today again in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because the wind is going to blow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Another thing that we can see in that story is the wilderness experience. We normally talk about dry bones as our dry lands. As a wilderness experience. When you are walking in the wilderness experience or in the dry land, I don't know if anybody, well, we heard the story about the desert, how hot, dry, and there is no life. Everything seems to be stagnant over there. That is how it feels when the wind is not blowing. But when the wind blows in the dry land, in that wilderness experience, that which has been considered as dead is restored back to life in the name of Jesus Christ. And when we read the book of Mark chapter 10, verse 46 to 52, Mark chapter 10, verse 46 to 52, we saw also a story that we know very well, the story of blind Bartimaeus. That is a typical story of someone living in the dry land or having a dry experience, wilderness experience, so to speak. Blind Bartimaeus was born blind. He was a beggar. He was living on the streets. He was outside the city because the people in the city became his enemy because he's been too much burden on them. So they have to push him out. So he has to go out to beg for money, to beg to eat. Everything about blind Bartimaeus was so dry. Everything about him was so dry. But one day, the wind blows towards him. The Holy Ghost carrier himself carried the wind and build towards Him. I pray that the Lord Jesus Christ will visit you this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. And what happened to him? He, who was a cast out, living in the dry situation, when the wind blew towards him, he became the center of attraction. Even his enemies were calling him to come and sup together. They were calling him to come and visit them. See, the Bible says, if a man's way pleases Lord, he causes his enemy to be at peace with him. I pray for every wilderness experience today, that in the name that is above every other name, if we are going through that wilderness experience, it shall end today in the name of Jesus Christ. So quickly, point number four, what do we see in this story that we just read? We also see that when the wind blows, destiny is restored. Hallelujah. When the wind blows, destiny is restored. You know the story of Moses. When Moses was born, in Exodus chapter 3, read from verse 1 going. When Moses was born, there was death around him. They were looking at killing everyone of that caliber at that time. The mother hid him for 3 months. And after that, you have to take Moses to the palace. To Pharaoh. He grew up with Pharaoh, until he realized that that wasn't his destiny. And he realized that if he stayed in that palace, his destiny would be lost forever. So he decided to leave. I pray that God will open your eyes, that you will see that which He has proposed for your life in the name of Jesus Christ, and you will pursue it diligently with Him in the name of Jesus Christ. So when Moses was cast out from Egypt, he went to the wilderness. The Bible says he stayed there till 80 years old. At that time, I would be asking myself, is it really true? God, do you have something for me? What you have spoken about my life, is it this life? But God's time is the best. He does everything beautifully at His own time. That is why I pray that we will be patient enough to wait for Him to do His own work in our lives. When God revisited Moses in that wilderness, that day the Bible says his destiny was restored. Hallelujah. Our destiny will be restored in the name of Jesus Christ. What about Joseph? We know the story of Joseph very well. Joseph was having good, beautiful dreams. His brothers, he saw the brothers coming to bow before him. He was like, he saw himself being the head of many people. And what happened to him? He was sold to a slavery. You ask yourself, what kind of life is this? And not only he was sold into the slavery, he ended up in the prison. So if God, you are opening my eyes to see all these beautiful things in my life that is coming in, and I'm finding myself in prison, I will begin to doubt God. But you know what he did? He says, God has spoken. And because he knows his God, that whatever God says shall come to pass, he decided to wait for God's own glorious time. Hallelujah. Many of us, we also have dreams like that. Dreams to become somebody great. No, dreams for success. Maybe dream to become the CEO of a reputable company. Or dream to become a great evangelist. Or dream to become a great leader. But we're looking at our lives today and we're asking ourselves, we're asking questions. Is this dream coming to pass? Well, I have a good news for you today. If you can wait and trust in God, when his beautiful time comes, you will see that Bill's destiny will be restored to you in the name of Jesus Christ. And the Bible tells us in the story, it says, when Ezekiel prophesies unto the bones, they became a single great army. And I can trust you, when they became the army and they found themselves that they were in the valley, they will march out as soldiers in that valley in the name of Jesus Christ. You see, they march out from that valley. They receive a change of location. They find themselves that where they are, that is not where they're supposed to be. So they received a change of location. And I pray that when the wind blew this morning, you will receive the change of locations in the name of Jesus Christ. You know, there was a story in 1 Samuel chapter 16, a story about David. Before David was made king, Samuel went to the house of Jesse to appoint a king. And when he got to that house, all the big boys were there. But David was missing. He was in the bush with the sheep, and he's laying among the sheep. But when the wind blew on his way, and I said to you that if the wind blew on your way, it doesn't matter where you are. Even if you are in the place that no one can see you, the wind will come unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. He was in the wilderness with the sheep. But when the wind blew, he was brought up from the wilderness to the palace. So shall it be your portion in the name of Jesus Christ. You know why I know that? Because the same 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 8, 1 Samuel chapter 2 verse 8 says, he rises the poor from the dust and lifts the beggar from the ashes heap. To set them among who? Princes. And make them inherit the throne of glory. David was taken from the wilderness and was set where? Into the palace. And he made him to inherit the throne of glory. So shall it be for you in the name of Jesus Christ. That is how your destiny will be restored. And quickly, before we go to prayer, when the wind blows, anything that is irreversible in your life shall be reversed in the name of Jesus Christ. The man of God said, this is beyond my prophecy, but only you, God. Because he saw that this cannot be reversed. The bone was so dry that no one can even put his faith on it. So it is a dead situation. But when the wind blew, all the things that were irreversible were reversed in the name of Jesus Christ. There is a God, and that is the God that we serve. The God that reverses all the irreversible, because all things are possible. And he told Martha, he says, didn't I tell you that if you believe, you shall see the glory of God? This morning, if you believe God, you shall see his glory in your life. Amen. Let us pray.